Atari 2600, the seminal gaming console. The Xbox calls it grandpappy. For kids, it was a quarter-saving goddess. The 2600 had all the great games. Adventure, Battlezone, Asteroids, Yar's Revenge, and even the ever-stimulating Pong. Sure, we all loved it when we were kids, but you wouldn't want to play one today because, face it, it's an 8-bit piece of crap. Still, you can't go wrong keeping the wood grain fossil around. The 2600 looks pretty freaking cool. So the question is, can someone make something useful out of this relic from the 80s? Meet Chad and Tim. They're cool. They're edgy. You can tell by the black and white footage. Can they cram an iBook into the empty husk of an Atari 2600? Stay tuned to MyMax MacMOD to find out.
Okay, Tim. So here we are in the shop. Why do we have a 2600 sitting here?
Well, because it's probably the best video game system in the world.
Well, I agree with that. I mean, I had one when I was a kid, but there's a lot better out there right now.
Well, there's something to be said for old school. And because this program is called MacMod, we have to take a Macintosh computer and modify into something else.
Well, we're not going to fit a G5 in there, that's for sure.
No, I don't think the wind tunnel fans is going to quite do it. So we're going to have to go with that iBook that we got sitting over there. It's a 500 megahertz iBook, dual USB.
Mm.
It's ready to go. It's already got Panther on it, 10.3. It's sweet. It's jamming. Do you like my screen on there?
Yeah, I do. It's the iAtariMac.
iAtariMac. That's going to be the name of this project, actually. This is going to be the iAtariMac. When I say this, what we're going to do is we're going to take that machine and we're going to stuff it in here. It, you know, that's pretty thin, and that's not.
Right.
So that shouldn't be a problem. So I guess the first thing that we need to do today is we need to take this apart.
Yep.
Anything you need to do?
I need to take some measurements along the bay right here so we know where all our ports are, how wide we need to cut a space in the actual chassis for. And also I need to get a measurement on that back side where we've got the...
The power?
Well, and the CD as well. Since we're probably going to have to use that same mechanism to open and close it, we need to know how wide we're going to have to cut a spot for that as well.
I think we're going to have to... Once we get this apart and seeing what it looks like inside there, whether the CD stays on the side, on the Atari as it does here.
Yeah, we have no idea how mobile this thing is going to be or how we can move these components around until we actually get them out.
Right. We also still have to worry about the power button,
where
we're going to put that on the Atari. So.
Yep.
I guess the first thing, I'll let you get your measurements, and then I'm going to start taking apart this iBook.
All right.
One of the questions I had that the iBook does have these two little speakers built in, do you want to try to use them in the Atari or just not even worry about it?
I think we should. I think we can probably, once again, depending on how much space we have, we could probably either just drill some little holes right in here or along the sides and mount them on the inside of the cabinet.
Because we're going to have external speakers on it, obviously. I mean,
right.
It's going to be USB, so. Speaking of external parts, the intrepid MyMac.com webmaster, Adam, sent us this nice little thing that's going to allow us to hook up a VGA monitor.
Excellent.
So this is just going to plug into here, the external monitor out port, and we're all ready. So
okay.
The iBook screen is history. It's going bye-bye, and we'll auction it off on eBay sometime if we don't wreck it. You know.
Right.
So let's, you know, like I've told you before, we do have the manual.
Right.
So we're just going to close that because we don't care about manuals.
No,
we're going to do this the hard way. going to figure out
how to
completely destroy this thing. I don't know. Do you think we ought to start underneath, or do you think we ought to start with the keyboard?
Well, is there anything we can get to by removing the keyboard?
Oh, yeah, you can get to the airport card and the hard drive.
Excellent.
All
right.
You got a screwdriver. This thing is... Oh, never mind. I got it.
Cell phone.
kill the cell phone.
Got it?
Yeah, I just wonder if that little piece that just went flying was important or not.
Well, I'll go take a look and see if I can find it. What would it look like?
A little piece.
Ah.
Ah, look at this.
Yeah.
You know, I'm sure there's a correct way of taking this apart.
No,
this isn't it.
There is.
Join us next time on MacMOD when someone just might lose a finger.